Well guys, what's going on? This is Ben Cramp Paulson from Happen Graphics, and today I'm giving you guys a quick tutorial. I know this channel is not about giving you guys tutorial, it's about giving you free stuff that you guys can use in your workflow. Last time I gave you guys the alien skin, and today I'm going to give you a quick plugin called Norlight, remade by Red Giant. It's a very great plugin that you guys can use in your workflow. This plugin is about giving you guys different sources of light that you can use in your images, landscape photography, any types of lights you guys need to just make your workflow very nice. It contains a whole lot of presets. Looking at the speed art on how you guys can use, you can trigger the settings, you can do anything, any color you want. You can use this plugin for a whole lot of stuff, guys. Okay guys, so here this is my, yes, I'm Crampa Wilson. You can find me on Instagram, Crampa_Wilson. And today I'll be giving this guy a quick tutorial on how to create a scene, but we'll be using this Red Giant Norlight in our workflow. So you open a folder, you unsubstract it, you open it and you check you have the system properties of 64 and 32 bit. So you check your system, the version you are on 64 bit. So I will install the 64 bit. If you're on 32, you install the 32 bit. But for now, I've already installed it. So you open it, any permission it asks you, just grant or just press yes and continue. I've given you guys the serial if at all. I already have it. So after installing, so this is the serial that you guys will be using. You just copy it and paste it if you demand for it. After that, just go back to the folder you extracted, the Red Giant Norlight software. Then, so right now I've already have it, so I'll just cancel. So just copy the Norlight folder, open your program files, locate your Adobe products folder, locate the Photoshop version you are using, CSS CC 2019-2020, I'm using 2019-2022. I'll just go to my 2019 folder, find the plugin folder and just paste the Norlight or the Nor software in that plugin folder and you're good to go. So right now if you launch your Photoshop version, you go to your folder, you find Norlight and you're good to go to use it. So right now this is the quick tutorial on how to create a scene. The name of this scene, entitled last word, just about someone about to be killed and he's being asked to say his last word before they shoot him or kill him. So I had my stock images from unsplash.com. I'll be giving you this guy the project file, contains all the stock and the finished product. You guys can tweak it. So right now I'll just do a quick selection of the cloud using the quick selection. You can refine it using your selector marks or a refine edge or any means of refining it. Since I've given you guys the stock images, so I'll be setting the main blending mode I'll be using will be the color dodge and the screen mode. Nice and easy. So make sure you also make a backup or you convert your stuff into a smart filter so that you can access it anytime you want to make some little bit of tweaks and come back and do it. You'll be adding a little blur, you're adding a bokeh to the clouds or to the sky to give it like as if there's stars in the sky. So a little bit of blur, I'm adding some little bit using the foot blur. I'll be giving you guys another plugin next video, another blur plugin that can give you a very good look. We're adding a little bit of some curves to darken it a little bit. we adjust the settings according to the way we want it. So you guys should be playing around. So one, let me say something little here. So one thing you guys have to do is, in creating a scene or in composite or an editing, what you guys need to know is that everything is built up from step. Let's start an editing. You just have to build it. Stop adding a little bit of light, shadows, some brightness and contrast, some highlights. You guys know what I'm talking about. So you take your time to build it. So as time goes on, you see that what you are creating is becoming realistic. So you just have to take your time on anything you do. Don't rush. Take your time. If you are tired, just rest. Or if you are not having any idea, just pause the editing, save the project, come back again with new fresh mind and continue. That's one thing about editing. It's not about creating something in a haste. Just have to have your time and create it. So let's continue with the quick tutorial. So I had this filling station, so I added a little bit of glare to the filling station. That's where my subject will be. And I added some little bit of depth of field. Look at the background, it's a little bit blurry. So these are my images that I'll be using. I had an image of a man on the desert holding some sands. And I'll be making a quick cut. But for now, let me adjust some settings because looking at the color doesn't suit very well. So I'll be using my alien skin. I've given you guys this plugin. You can check in my previous video. You find the alien skin plugin link and download it and install it. It's just like an alternate of the Adobe Camera Raw. You have a lot of settings inside. So I'm adjusting my settings and apply. I'll be making a quick selection of him. I'll be using the paint tool. I'll be speeding up this process a little bit. I like using the pen tool, it's very quick for me. I also have a plugin that I'll be using to make selections. I'll be giving you that plugin, guys, in my other video. So you guys make sure you subscribe to this channel. You follow me on Instagram at @grandpa_Wilson. I have my links in the description. Any file you need is being, which will be linked below. So make sure you follow me. I also have my Telegram group. You guys can join my Telegram group, and I'll be posting a whole lot of content over there for free. So you guys can also check him up on there. And I'm making a quick selection of him. This is an image I had on Splash, and I thought this would be good in my composite. So I downloaded this image. I made a quick cut of him. I'll be making some little bit of a refine using a selected mask, and I think it's okay because things don't have to be that all my detail. Just add a little bit of necessary things to make it more realistic. So guys, this is what I'm going to do. This is another image in my head from Unsplash, and I think this image was also perfect for the scene. So I also make a quick selection from the paint tool, make a quick selection. And what I have to say is that most of these images you get have different color, have different colors, have different color grading. So you guys have to just sit down and ask yourself what will be your end color grading that I'll be using. Make sure all the images you downloaded from different sources have the same color grading to make your editing nice and accepted anywhere you post it. So looking at this, color grading is different from where I had the man. So I have to make some little bit of adjustment using the alien skin, or all those using the Adobe Camera Raw. You can access the Camera Raw and make some little bit of changes in it. But I prefer using the alien skin because I have more control over there. And I think that's what I've been using recently. And I hope you guys will also love it. So if you don't have the alien skin, go check my previous video or my previous tutorial to download that plugin. So during composite, I try to put some of my subjects in some location. And during the process of editing, I find out that is not suitable. So I don't know how you guys, everybody has their preference and how they edit. So looking at the image at the background, I think I'll be changing the position. I also make a quick selection. I have this image on Google, and I think it's a free image. and I'll do a quick selection. I'll be doing some refining to make it look good. Over there, so I did a little bit of edit on his leg, adjusted his body a little bit to look downwards as if you're looking at the man, and adjusted the body pose a little bit. So this is what I was talking about, drawing the pose setting, removing your images here and there, subject here and there, just to get the stand or the quality that you want. So this is another image I had on Splash. I also make a quick selection using a pen too. I always use a pen to make my selection. I made a quick selection of him too. I'll be placing him at the background and I'll be blending him a little bit. So then selection it isn't that much active because he'll be out of focus. So I think yeah, that's cool. And made a quick selection. You guys can use any means of selection you love best. Some use the quick selection, some use the pen tool, some other use any means of selection, but I normally use the pen tool. You can refine using your selector max panel, and it will be placing at the background and run this process. You think of where you're going to place it, but looking at the edits, as time goes on and the concept is coming, or as you getting new ideas, you later change his position and place him somewhere that will look very cool. So placing over there was not that cool. The man in the black, you have to resize and then send him back a little bit since he was far from the camera after even playing. Looking at this, the filling station and the depth of those, I have to add a similar thing on him to make him out of focus. But I have to add a little bit of shadow to him also. And also looking at the lady in the black dress, also I have to make a little bit of things. Also have to place him over there. I'll later be making some position changes. I also add a little bit of blur to him. So that guy, I have to even send him at the back more and position him a little bit to make him fit the ground level. So scaling, resizing, just to get the position you want for it to look more realistic. It depends on a lot of time, position the subject, and you look at how he or she is, and you see it doesn't fit. You have to make some changes, make it fit more. So we'll be adding some little bit of brightness and contrast. We're adding some highlights to our subjects. So looking at where the cat is, you can see a little bit of light source over there. So we'll be adding some little bit of some highlights on the cat. Added some little bit of blur because looking at the background is out of focus, so you have to duplicate that same effect on the cat and also the man with the gun. We'll add a little bit of shadow. Normally take a gray color and I'll change the blending mode to multiply. I'll add a little bit of glare, reduce the opacity on the fill. So apply the same settings on the alien screen and apply it to most of the subjects there, so that we'll all get that same look. So this is where we'll be adding the null light. Shop. So you can pick your settings according to what you desire. You can adjust the glow, the spread, the color. You can adjust a whole lot of settings in it. So guys, you have to try it for yourself, install it, and you will love it. So we need to create some source of light. So since you have the HSL, the hue, saturation, and luminance, you can adjust the color anytime you want. But best thing is you guys should convert it to a smart filter, so you can tweak anything again in case if you like to. So add a little bit of glare and position at the far left, and I can change the color using my hue and saturation. So during this edit, I had a color in mind to give that cyan look. So it's enough for us to add some little bit of shadow. So I'll first add the face shadow, that will blur a little bit. Then I'll add some contrast shadows. Then I'll add some little bit of brightness and contrast to him. Then I'll have to paint it. Look as if the ground and his skin was in contact. I'll add a little bit of shadows. So this thing, you have to take your time when you're doing this, guys, because creating this to be realistic, it takes a whole lot of time. So you have to take your time and paint. I'm doing all this thing, I'm using a mouse, but I'm having a graphic tablet, so you guys should give me an A+ for that. If you like this video, I need to show likes for this video. So make sure you share, you like, you comment, and more updates on tutorial every week. Okay, so I had some little bit of tricks to the guy since it's not the that app. So I used the puppet warp to lift up his hands a little bit, and I'll start painting some highlights. So right now I wanted to give that look, so cinematic look. So I added some little bit of green lights and giving him some highlights. And I hope you guys downloaded my presets, my LUT, my LUT, 3D LUT preset, because we'll be using that preset here. And if you don't have that preset, please check my previous videos. You're gonna see that video downloaded that preset, because that preset normally give me a very good look that I really love. And applying this green highlight on it and you using that LUT will make it very nice. You guys should watch to the end and you see what is going to happen to the scene. So right now we are creating the scene a little bit and it's becoming realistic a little, but we're not yet done yet. So we're adding a whole lot of colors, painting, shadow, contrast shadow, and a whole lot, so that to make it realistic. So take your time when you're painting highlights. I normally paint and use the motion blur to push it a little bit. So looking at the images, they know they all have different colors, but we have to blend them well. So I normally use the motion blur to spread the highlights around the subject a little bit, and I normally use the add lights or color dodge screen mode. Add a little bit of blur to it, and if more, you can reduce the fill or the opacity to make it look cool. So let's also paint with another color. So also have some highlights. These highlights are not done realistic because we'll be using the plugin or the 3D LUT preset, and applying that preset is going to make this scene look totally different and look very realistic and cool. We're adding some little bit of some elements in this scene, so guys, wait for what is going to happen at the end. So hope you guys subscribe to this channel. You can follow me on Instagram at crampandeforwholesing. All the links is found below. I have my Telegram group. You guys can join the group, and I'll put a whole lot of stuff there. You can find that group on my Instagram. You check my highlights, you find all my links over there. You can join, and I'll be creating a group for which we all can discuss a whole lot of stuff. So guys, make sure you subscribe to this channel, because more content are coming on this channel. A whole lot of free stuff are coming, so we're adding some lights. Since we're creating some highlights, we'll have to add some lights indicating where the source of light is coming from that we're creating a highlight. So we'll have to duplicate that highlight or the light from that source on our subjects. So this is going to this will, if you are doing this as something that you are going to aim from, I bet you that you guys should just take your time and construct, or take your time and do anything you want to do, because you're going to aim from that. But if you're doing it as your hobby, you can choose to do it clean or. But what I prefer is to just take your time, and anything you do, just take your time and do it to bring you a very nice outcome or result. Don't forget to add some blur, and if it's too much, you have the opacity and the fill, you can reduce it to make it look more cooler. You have to add the same light on the cat, since the light source is coming from the right hand side, so you have to add some highlight. And as usual, I normally draw and add a little bit of blur and change the blending mode to screen color dodge or soft light or hard light. So within the scene, you are developing the scene a little bit. So since the image are not real blended, you have to do a whole lot of adjustment to it. I have to add some highlights on our main subject, who's going to be killed. And this is a concept I had earlier, and I plan that I have to do a tutorial on it, because my tutorials are not going to be that much difficult to understand. They're all stepwise direction. The only thing you need to do is just download. If you don't understand anything, just watch the video over and over, download it, watch it over and over, add it to your playlist, or add it to your liked videos. If you like it, you always have access to that video anytime you want. So we'll be slowly adding our highlight, because we want the scene to be more realistic. So we're adding our highlight and our source of light. Make sure you always create a new highlight on a new layer, so you can come back and tweak it. We need to change some settings. So I'm using the HSL, the Hue Saturation Luminance. I was using the sliders to change the color of the logo of the shell. I want to change the color over there. So we change the color, we invert it. Then use the brush and select a white color, then paint over to add a little bit. Let's add a little bit of glow. So paint over with a low opacity brush, change the blending mode to color dodge, reduce the opacity a little bit. We'll be adding the preset very soon, the 3D LUT I created. I also have that pack on my channel. Check my YouTube videos, you find my preset pack. Hope you download that pack. It contains five presets. You guys should download that preset, and it's very cool if you want to get that cyan look. that cinematic look. I have that preset for free. Just have to just check the link in the description and download that. Watch the video. If you don't understand how you use it, just watch the video and you're going to understand how you use it. So looking at the environment and looking at the lady, you have to make some little bit of color adjustment. You can use the color balance, but sometimes I prefer using the HSL since you have more control over, and we just have to change the embed the layer mask and paint with white on anywhere we need that color to be. So we're gonna paint and look at the lady wearing the dark space. You have to send her a little bit at the. So still on the highlight, you have to paint more of highlights. So make sure you change your blending mode to linear light. I normally use the color dodge, the screen, the linear light, the soft light, the hard light, and I think what else, color dodge, they are very cool using it, that blending mode. So I'll still be adding the light source. And I'm adding some elements. So guys, right now I've used the preset that I told you guys about, the preset that you can find on my YouTube channel. Download the preset. This is the preset I've applied to. Now look at what it's giving me right now. So we're adding some little bit of other elements, like him holding a sword. Is that a sword? Okay, let's call it a sword, because finding a whole lot of elements on the internet was very difficult. So I have to add some sword and him holding a sword. Is that a sword? A knife? Is that a knife? A machete? Okay, anyway guys, huh? Anyway you call it, but I would say it's a knife. So having something like a blood in his hand, like him killed someone, or he used his hand to kill someone and there's blood in his hands. And I have to paint a little bit of shadow over that side. So adding a little bit of dust, or so add some elements of another cat by giving it that depth of thought. So I'm gonna blur the cat a little bit, darken him to give that depth of field, and this looks very cool if you do this. Also add some highlight of that cyan look to the cat. So during the color grading process, I used two plugins. So let's say I use the inbuilt Adobe Camera Raw. I've already done a settings inside. I've already done some settings in Adobe Camera Raw. I've saved it as a preset, and I'll be applying it when I'm done yet, and I want to complete my final color grading. And we'll be using Alien Skin from scratch. We'll build our own preset from scratch using the Alien Skin. And one thing about Alien Skin is, If you apply settings and it looks good to you, just have to save that preset, so that next time there's no need for you to come back to push some slides and to do a whole lot of stuff again. Just have to just save that preset. You just tap on it and it applies to your picture to go. So I think one tip I'll give to you guys is, you guys should normally create presets for yourself and save it well, so that you'll be using it on your images. And this is what I'll be doing. I'll be showing you guys the Camera Raw, and I'll show you the Alien Skin, how I also build the final look for my image or for my scene. So now this is the scene you've created, and it looks cool to me, and I'll be posting this on my Instagram. So make sure you check my Instagram, crampa_Wilson. I'll post all my stuff over there. You can also find me on ArtStation. I'm also found on Twitter. So this camera roll, these are my presets. So this is my preset that I've applied. This is the preset I created, and look at how it is. Looks cool. I'll also be building this preset from scratch. So let's create a snapshot of what we did, and now let's go to our alien skin. If you don't have the alien skin, check the link in the description. You have the link over there. Download the alien skin plugin. So right now we'll be going to alien skin, but make sure anytime you get into alien skin, you reset your panel or your workflow, you reset it, then we'll start from scratch. So now we'll push the temperature, or some will push the contrast a little bit, and a little bit of the highlight, reduce the little bit of shadows and the white, and we'll push the so look at the before and after. We'll add some little bit of clarity and drawing the details. You can use curves. Let's fade, add some little bit of fade, and let's go to our color. This way the settings are the HSL, hue, saturation, and luminance. You tweak the settings according to what you feel or what looks cool to you. Tweak the settings. You can find all this in Adobe Camera Raw, but I would like using the alien skin because alien skin is also cool. You can add a whole lot of overlays in the alien skin. So looking at the images we've got for different sources and putting it in one scene, I think this looks great, and this takes a whole lot of time, but I made it very short for you guys to just understand the concept and the things you need. So always add a high pass. So just duplicate your layer, go to linear light blending mode, and just go to filter order, then you add a high pass to give you that pass. You also have a plugin that you can also use to give you that detail. My name is Crampa Wilson, and you can find my Instagram at crampa_Wilson. You can check the link in the description. I have my Telegram group over there, you can join. Also, you can follow me on Twitter. You can also subscribe to my channel. You can also like the video, you can comment, you can share so that your friends will also see it. So see you guys in the next